It's hard to imagine that it has already been 1 year since Tata Motors launched the Altroz. And on its first anniversary, Tata has given it a turbo petrol engine to woo those looking for the thrill of driving. This test will obviously dive deep into what's new on the Altroz iTurbo and how it drives. But we also have here with us the benchmark hatchback for driving enthusiasts, the Polo TSI. And it's here to give us a sense of perspective, to set the goalposts for the Altroz iTurbo. Welcome to Evo India, I'm Karan Singh. Hit the bell icon to stay notified, subscribe to the channel and leave a thumbs up if you liked the video. Before we jump into the driver's seat, let's talk about what's new on the Altroz iTurbo. The first thing that catches your eye is this bright harbor blue paintwork. Especially in the sunlight, the sparkles really come out and make the Altroz's design pop. Talking of design, not much has changed in terms of design on the Altroz, but the Altroz hasn't been around for too long. What is new is this iTurbo badge. It signifies the 1.2-litre turbo petrol engine lurking under the bonnet. And now let's take a look at what's changed on the inside. First and foremost is this lighter theme for the cabin with the light grey finish on the plastics. The second big change here are the leatherette seats and the leatherette covered armrest. Now the next change in here is something that we've seen on the Nexon before. It is this Express Cool button. Essentially what it does is ramp up the air conditioning to cool the cabin a lot faster than if you were to turn up the AC to full. I'll give you a demo, but a warning here is that the wind noise gets quite loud. So as you can see, it lowers the window to let the hot air out and blasts the cabin with cool air. This also gives me a good time to tell you that it does get one-shot up power windows now. Now the next change in here is connected car technology. There's an app called Aira, and with that you get the usual things of geofencing, locking and unlocking the car, and you also now get Hinglish voice commands. Now the other change in here is this sport mode button, which is exclusive to the Altroz iTurbo, and it basically sharpens up the throttle responses and makes the engine a little bit more eager. Aside from those small updates, not much has changed in the cabin of the Altroz. But then again, the Altroz has only been around for 12 months. It doesn't feel dated and it has all the technology you'll need. So Apple CarPlay is here, Android Auto is here, you have automatic climate control, rain sensing wipers. Basically, all the equipment you expect from any car in this segment, the Altroz iTurbo has it. Tata Motors is no stranger to making fast hatchbacks. The Tiago JTB was one of the most fun to drive hatchbacks around, but that was before the plug was pulled on JTB, and that was that. Fast forward to 2021 and we now have the Altroz iTurbo, and the big change here is the engine. It is a 1.2-litre turbo petrol unit that makes 108 bhp and 140 nm of torque. And in a word, it is smooth. This 1.2-litre turbo petrol engine is mated to a 5-speed manual gearbox, and it is fairly slick. Not as smooth as some Japanese boxes, it does have a little more tactility to it, but I honestly prefer that. We were expecting Tata Motors to launch the Altroz iTurbo with either a DCT or maybe even a standard torque converter automatic, but they haven't done so, and there's no news on when that'll arrive. So if you prefer to keep your left leg rested, the Polo or the i20 are your only choices here. Now in terms of ride and handling, the Altroz iTurbo is almost unchanged from the standard Altroz, which is a very, very good thing. The Altroz's ride was exceptional and it is the same here. It handles bad roads really, really well, and it is also great for highway runs and super comfortable in the city as well. Now the advantage of the iTurbo is that the more powerful engine lets you explore the chassis' capabilities a bit more. And when you push it hard into corners, there is a fair bit of body roll, if I'm honest. There is also a lot of understeer, but that understeer might just be down to the eco tires that are fitted onto this Tata Altroz iTurbo. So if you're buying one, I suggest getting some stickier rubber and you should have plenty of fun around bends. The iTurbo engine should make the Altroz appeal to a much wider audience than before, even though there aren't too many changes on the Altroz itself. And talking of a car without changes, we head to the Volkswagen Polo. We'll be right back. Now, while the Altroz celebrates its first birthday, the Polo is past its 10th. And over the years, the Polo has evolved continuously, but not really comprehensively. And that means that the cabin of this new Polo is very similar to the first one that came out. That isn't particularly a bad thing, considering the fit and finish is generally pretty good. And you do get a lot of equipment. So you have Apple CarPlay, you have Android Auto, you have automatic climate control. It doesn't feel Spartan, but it isn't what you'd call cutting edge. But the truth is that it all fades to oblivion when you start to drive it. The new 1-litre TSI is a punchy, lively engine with a meaty torque band, and it is mated to the 6-speed torque converter automatic, which is calibrated quite well for the engine. It can fumble a shift or two at times, but there's nothing to complain about really. This engine makes 108 bhp and 172 nm of torque, which is more than before, and the chassis is more than capable of handling that extra oomph. The Polo genuinely leaves a smile on your face every single time you drive it hard, and that is exactly what has helped it reach the top of our recommendations list when the thrill of driving is concerned. Now, how do these two compare? Well, the Altroz iTurbo has a smoother, more linear power delivery, which makes it easier to drive in the city. And the maneuverability around town is also helped by the fact that the Altroz has a lighter steering as well. On the other hand, the Polo's 1-litre TSI engine has a more significant punch, a nicer sound, and the extra 30-odd nm of torque can certainly be felt when you flow the throttle. It also feels more planted around corners thanks to a better chassis and a heavier steering. But the question is, which one should you spend your money on? We've always loved the Altroz's ride and handling, and perhaps all it was missing was an enthusiastic powertrain. The iTurbo engine certainly changes things. It makes the Altroz more eager and gives it a layer of fun that it never had before. The Altroz is also much nicer to live with, thanks to a more spacious cabin and a lot more equipment. We also expect the Altroz iTurbo to undercut the Polo in terms of pricing. So, if you're looking for a fun-to-drive, practical hatchback, the Altroz iTurbo would be our pick of the two. But for maximum driving pleasure, the Polo TSI is still the king.
Subscribe to the Evo India channel and hit the bell icon to keep pace with the thrill of driving.